you a little devotional thought that I didn't have time for. This is actually the second half of my sermon, so I'm just going to finish this off with that. We're going to have you out of here so you can go finish Father's Day. And I know a lot of the teens are going out to their end of school year thing out at the lake, so they're at the beach too. We're at this beach, they're at a real beach, so that's how that goes. But we're glad you're here, and we're going to have a word of prayer, and we're going to get started, and I will introduce these guys. I've been told, all three of y'all are single, right? None of y'all are married? I mean, I know you couldn't travel with your wife, because I get it, but I've been told that KMBC, I always understood it stood for Kentucky Mountain Bible College. But then I knew Tyrell went down there, and he found Joanna, and Cassie went down there, and she found Freddie. So they said they changed the name to Kentucky Mountain Bridal College. So that's, have y'all heard that already? Probably every place you go, huh? Let's pray, and we're going to turn it over to them. All right, Father God, we bless you tonight. We thank you, Lord, that it's a Sunday evening, and we're in your house to worship you in spirit and in truth. So, Lord, tonight, these young men who travel around on their summers off, representing not only KMBC, but you, Father, their lives are a witness. They bear witness of who you are in their lives, and that excites me to see young people, young men, stepping up. We preached about that this morning. So, Lord, bless them tonight. Bless us through them, and may your spirit fall on this place tonight. May we rejoice. As David said, I was glad when they said, let us go into the house of the Lord, our God. Father, bless us in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Anthem Trio. Come on, guys. Give them another hand while they come.
Graduated from Bible College last month, And I feel that God is calling me to use my gifts and talents to work full-time Christian radio as well as the worship ministry. So I'll be there on campus at KMBC working full-time.
It's good to be here this evening. My name is Elliot, and I'm all the way from a small town called North Pole, Alaska. And it's not the North Pole, but it's a small town up there. And I see that you guys welcomed me with some sunny background, so I don't know if that's a joke or something you knew. But no, it's good to be here. I'm a freshman at the college, and God has led me to study youth ministry. It's given me a true passion and desire to study His Word and to study how to reach youth around the world.
My name is Zachary. I'm from Lancaster, Kentucky. It's just south of Lexington. And I just finished my first year in college. I was led there to grow in evangelism and music ministry. Being here with you guys today is an answer to a lot of prayer and continue to worship with us as we praise our Lord.
There is a song.
There is a song.
I do want to make mention of some people I see here in the crowd. Of course, Tyrell and Joanna went to school, had some classes with them at KMBC. I'm good to see them there. And Freddie and his wife also went to school at KMBC. And then my old class sponsored on this evening. Walls of Jericho falling down all the way. Let's see if this works. Anyways, my old class sponsors, John and Katie Mathis and their family, they're here tonight as well. They were our class sponsors for several years there at Kentucky Mountain Bible College, and they were actually able to come down for our graduation, which was very special. Great to see you guys here. I didn't get to talk to you before the service. I'll make sure to catch you afterwards. Kentucky Mountain Bible College, if you look at the typical university model, university is made up of several different colleges. Depending on what one wants to go into for a career, they'll go into a degree of studies. You know, you'll have your College of Law, Agriculture, Medicine, etc. But Kentucky Mountain Bible College is one of those specific colleges, and they are dedicated to training their students for one particular thing, and that is Christian service and ministry. A study from George Barna, I believe, said that 80% of those who go into the ministry drop out after less than 5 years of being in the ministry. That's a very startling statistic when we think of the world that needs to be reached for Christ, all the unsaved people in the world. Well, Dr. Spees, our president, he heard about this study and wanted to do one of his own, and found that over a long period of time, 70% of our graduates go into some form of ministry after they graduate from KMBC. And 80% of those people stay in there all the way through retirement. And that is just an amazing testimony of what God has been doing at our school, how he's been working through the lives of our students and graduates. And I've told people, even just 1 year at KMBC can make a huge difference in just solidifying your walk with Christ and building that foundation that you need in your life. One of my favorite things about KMBC is the workers there are not only focused on providing good academics, which they certainly do, but they have invested themselves in helping us grow into other areas of life as well, growing deeper in our walk with Christ, preparing us for life in general, and helping us develop good character traits are just some of the things that they're dedicated to helping us do. All three of us here, and anyone who has been at KMBC for classes or faculty and staff, have all been beneficiaries of this dedication and commitment that these people have made. I myself have personally benefited from this, what the St. Mathis has done in my life. But I want to talk about a few things that KMBC also has going on. We've launched our online program. We have 3 complete degrees that we offer online. So it doesn't matter if you're a pastor, Sunday school teacher, you just come to church on Sundays, whether you have a college degree or not, you can learn more about the God's Word right from the comforts of your own home. We offer degrees, I think, the associate's 2-year associate's degree, biblical studies 4-year degree, and a 4-year pastoral ministries degree. We have pamphlets out in the back on a display table. If you or someone you know might be interested in that, you come see us and ask us any questions you might have. Pick one of those up. By show of hands, who here receives KMBC's newsletter called The Silver Trumpet? I see a few hands. It is a newsletter that comes out about 3 or 4 times a year, and it just has a lot of stuff of what God has been doing in our school and how he's been impacting in the lives of our students. So Zach and Elliot are going to go around and sign a couple of those, just put in some basic information there, and we'll make sure that that gets to you. It is free of charge, by the way. Yeah, I know you don't hear that much in this world today that something is free, but this is free. We just ask that you read it when it is sent to you. We'll make sure it's sent to you. Now, how many of you also went to some form of youth camp or summer camp growing up? See the hands? All right, a lot of people here. Well, I was a Boy Scout in my teen years, and I always enjoyed summer camp and the fun times that had, being able to learn new skills and hang out with friends. KMBC has their own summer camp that we've been doing for quite some time now. I know myself and Zach have been to it. But it's been rapidly expanding over the last few years. Just up to maybe 4 years ago or so, we only had one week-long day for people to come. Now we have 3, just because of the amount of people that are coming in for youth camp. Like I said, I've been to it myself, and there are a lot of super fun activities, great times with friends. But the most important is the spiritual aspect that it has. We have a youth speaker that comes in and shares messages with youth throughout the week. And many of the youth there end up finding the answers that they're looking for, the questions that they're asking, and many of them make those solid commitments to God during youth camp. I know I did, and even our president, Dr. Spreece, you will attest to how youth camp has impacted his life. At this time, we have a short video promoting our youth camp and showing you the different activities we have this year. So if you could go ahead and play that, that'd be awesome. Usually we say a range from $10 to $1 million, whatever you feel like giving. You can take a CD home with you today if you've been enjoying this music. You can find more information about these things and others at our display table in the back, so feel free to stop by and ask us any questions you might have. At this time, I'm going to shut up and I'm going to ask the guys to come forward and we'll sing some more.
Personal testimony about how it was so crazy for me to wake up one day and realize I'm in Alaska. Wow, I'm living there. Has anybody ever been to Alaska? Has anybody ever been there? I know the Mathises actually just visited my parents there in January, and I walked up to them and I said, "You guys are lucky. You've been home before I've been home." I haven't been home in a while. But anyway, God has really worked in my life, and just it's been so amazing to look back upon the years and to realize how He is truly faithful. And people can say that over and over, but it's true. God is faithful.
Amen.
He is so real, and He works in our lives. I love sharing the story. I was a 14-year-old boy, didn't really understand what was going on. My dad talked to me, and He said, Elliot, I think we're moving to Alaska. And I looked at him and I'm like, what? And but God called my dad to become a pastor in Alaska and a minister. My mom and dad are doing such an amazing job there. And but I remember as a 14-year-old struggling through so many things and questioning why. God saw me in my bedroom crying and wondering what's going on. And God told me that he gave me my plan. He gave me my purpose. And I'm at college, I'm studying youth ministry, and as a 14-year-old kid struggling and going through some hard times, God gave me that call for youth ministry. God gave me that purpose. And I was so low, and I was questioning it. You know, everybody goes through those crossroads times. God gave me that calling, and he gave me that purpose. Elliot, I have a plan. And it's so amazing that if I just took the step with him, and if I keep taking the step with him, that he's just going to be faithful more and more and more. So I encourage you to do that tonight. It's so amazing to see, and I love testifying to the fact. I encourage you, keep taking the step. Keep walking with God.
Right.
Keep testifying to the fact that God is faithful, because he truly is.
Amen.
Job, and that's fun. Elliot was actually born in Jackson, Mississippi. He happened to notice that I'm wearing an Ole Miss tie. I had to go home and pray before I could let him sing, because he said he likes Mississippi State. That's the wrong school. But I relented and repented, and so we let him, and he did a great job. So
he didn't take off when he wanted.
Yeah, he's like, he was bothered by my tie.
His church or something. I don't know.
Oh, too funny. Well, you guys did a great job this morning. I'm going to ask you to do it again tonight. I don't like just begging for money, and I will never ask you to give money that I don't give first. So I got my check tonight. I had a $20 bill this morning I wanted to give away. Y'all piled up some money. I went over there, and there was two girls counting that money after church crying. She said we need between $250 and $300. That's what she told me, and that's what we stood up here and figured up. And you guys gave them $750 in 1 minute. In 1 minute, you raised $750. So tonight we're going to give an offering to Kentucky Mountain Bible College. We have the evidence, not just here, but in our own church, of the ministry of this school. So I'm going to ask you to write a check or to put some cash in an offering plate, and we're going to send them off with a blessing from this church to continue the work of Kentucky Mountain Bible College. I went to Bible college as well, not that one, but the school I went to closed. There aren't many true, pure Bible colleges left, and we need them. We need them desperately. So, and a lot of the guys down there are personal friends of mine that I've known, Tom Lormer and Dr. Spees, are guys I've known for going on 30 years. So this is very personal to me as well. We went down and did a working witness trip there years ago, if you remember. So we have a lot of connections to the Kentucky Mountain Bible College, and we're grateful for them. Mount Carmel High School as well. So ushers, if you'll come, I've given you time to write a check now. So let's try to do what we did this morning and maybe a little more than that. What do you think? I think it'd be great. I'm going to pray for the offering, and I need to pray tonight. It's actually Sandra's sister, Janice. Her husband, Don, is in ICU. Jane Ward is in the hospital in Des Moines. Linda Welch was here this morning. I don't think they're probably... No, I see Larry back there. But we need to continue to pray and just ask God to work in a lot of lives, a lot of lives. So let's pray for those needs, and then we're going to ask God to bless the offering. Then the guys are going to sing a little bit more. Heavenly Father, we bless you tonight for who you are. Lord, we have brought some physical needs before you right now. Lord, you know the needs. You know the realities of what's going on in the lives of people. I'm asking you right now in the strong name of Jesus to administer help and healing into lives, to bring times of refreshing when it's been a long season for some of these folks. God, I'm blessed to see Steve and Thelma here even tonight. God, we just pray your blessings into lives. Gary and Martha, Lord, sometimes the caregiver needs to be remembered. Father, you know all the needs before we even ask, and yet you ask us to ask. So, Lord, we're asking tonight. And, Father, we're grateful for these three young men. We pray God's blessings on their lives personally, their ministries for the future, their time at college. And now, Lord, we want to pray for KMBC. We pray you will bless, help, and encourage that school to fight the good fight and to continue training pastors, evangelists, missionaries, all that we need. Father, we need them, and we pray it all in Jesus' name. Amen. Christ alone.